Hi all, in this video we'll discuss about Azure DevOps Demo Generator. So the Demo Generator is a service which helps you provision projects in your Azure DevOps organization with pre-populated sample data like source code, work items, area and iteration path settings, your Kanban board settings, your build and release pipelines, and even project settings. All these are, you know, pre-populated using the Azure DevOps Demo Generator tool. The Demo Generator uses Azure DevOps APIs to provision projects and the content in your Azure DevOps organization. And the main purpose of Azure DevOps Demo Generator is to simplify the Azure DevOps learning process. To set up, I can say Demo Generator can be used to set up the Azure DevOps environment required for, let's say, for a pilot, for a POC, or to do a, you know, a training, or to do a demo for a customer. So we can quickly set up the demo environment with all the, you know, data, and we can start with the training or with the, you know, pilot project, which otherwise might take a lot of time, days or weeks together. But with Azure DevOps Demo Generator, it can be done in a couple of minutes. So let me sign in. So we can use we have to use the same credentials that we use for Azure DevOps to sign into the Demo Generator. And after signing into the Demo Generator, we have this home page, and where we can, you know, give the project name and select the DevOps organization and choose templates. See, the organization is basically my Azure DevOps organization, and based on my credential, it will list all the organization. So I can select one of the organization here, the DevOps organization, and click on choose template. So there are different tabs here, and each tab have a few templates. So templates are basically, it's kind of a logical container which has all the project data, the sample data, that I mentioned. It can be the source code, work items, project settings, all the data is available in the templates. So in the general tab, we have these, sample projects. Like, you would have seen these projects in the Microsoft portal, like Smart Hotel 360, Mile Clinic, Parts Unlimited. And in the DevOps Lab tab, we have again few more templates, basically to learn the different concepts or technologies and how that will work along with Azure DevOps. Like, for example, a Terraform or Ansible, or it can be like Octopus and Azure DevOps, how it functions. Or I want to see how I can use SonarQube along with the Azure pipelines, right? Or it can be I want to understand how to build and deploy a PHP application or a Python application. So these templates are supported by a detailed step-by-step guidance available in the AzureDevOpsLabs.com. Okay, so if you go here, this is a site. I'll make a separate video for this explaining about the AzureDevOpsLabs, .com, where there are a lot of different labs for different purposes. Okay, so basically here, it has given all the steps, and the first step is the prerequisites where we'll use the demo generator and then follow all the other steps. Okay, so this is DevOps Labs tab, and we have Microsoft Learn tab, and again this is again has a lot of templates, and this is again helps the individuals to learn the concepts of Azure DevOps. Like, I want to create a release pipeline with using the Azure DevOps, and again this is supported by the lab document. So this is the Microsoft Learn portal and supports the different learning paths or modules of Azure DevOps. So Again, we have all the steps here. Like for example, if I want to set up the environment, the prerequisites, and I may use the demo generator here. And rest of the steps I'll follow it after setting up using the demo generator, the environment, then I'll follow the rest of the exercise. Then there's Azure Community tab. So here we have a few templates. Again, these are contributed by, you know, different Microsoft teams or communities, which basically helps to deploy, let's say, Azure Sentinel or Windows Virtual Desktop using Azure DevOps. Then there's a Cloud Adoption Framework. So this also has a few more templates. So basically, Cloud Adoption Framework provides a guidance, best practices or methodologies to adopt cloud or to fast track the customers, you know, in adopting, you know, to the cloud, especially the Microsoft Azure. And then we have a private tab. Here we can create a project using our own templates. Yeah, so Azure DevOps Demo Generator helps us to create our own templates from the existing team projects we have in Azure DevOps. I can, you know, create my own template and use it to spin up more projects. Maybe I can show you that. Let me close this. And here you can see build your own template option. So let me click on that. And I can select the organization and the project which I want to, you can say, convert as a template or extract the data and create a template out of that. So let's say Parts Are Limited. This project I want to make as a template. So basically I click on analyze, which will fetch all the data from this project. Like it can be number of tasks, number of bug work items or any other work items. Then, you know, how many release pipelines are there, build pipelines are there, and other settings. So all these things, the data will be fetched, and then I can, you know, say create a template out of this, and either, you know, save it on the GitHub, you know, a portal where I can easily fetch it, or it can be hosted on my, you know, file sharing system or on my machine, right? So when I choose template, so I can, you know, once I store or save my the template either on my local drive, GitHub, or the other URLs, I can fetch the same giving the URL details, and then when I click on submit, I create a new team project out of the template. So that's the private tab. So this is mainly helpful for organization where they want to create a standardized process, a project with all the standard process, dashboards, everything, and that can be, you know, templatized. And any new projects we want to create, we can use, you know, once we have made our own template, then we can use that template and create, spin up new projects. Okay, so let me create a project and show it. So I'm choosing SmartRail 360. Again, this is one of the demo application done by Microsoft. Let me give the project name here. Say Smart Lab. And the demo generator also has an option of choosing a repo, like whether I can use Azure repos as my source control or I can go for GitHub. Yes, so if I choose GitHub, the source code, the sample source code of this application will be forked to my GitHub account, to my GitHub repo. So I can, you know, grant permission to one of the GitHub account and it will be forked. Or I can use by default the Azure repos. Also, the demo generator identifies the extensions or plugins which are required for the, you know, for the templates we have chosen. If it is not available, it will ask us for installation. Okay, so now let me create a project here. Yeah, you can see that the project is being created. While it's creating, Let me talk more about the usage of demo generator. Let's take an example or a scenario where I have to deploy a Python application and build and deploy the Python application using Azure DevOps, Azure pipelines, right? So for that, if I'm not using demo generator, I have to go and search for a sample repo or sample code of Python, and then figure out what are the steps or tasks, build task and release task available to compile to build this and deploy to, let's say, Azure App Services. Okay, and maybe even few work items have to be created. So to do this entire activity, I may take 2 3 days, or sometimes I may get stuck, it may take a weeks of time, right? But now let's say if I use demo generator, which has a Python or a PHP template, I choose that, and within a couple of minutes my team project is created with a sample Python application. My build pipeline is created with all the tasks. My release pipeline is created with all the release tasks which is required for the Python application. I have to just go through, verify, maybe do some small changes like give Azure service connection, authorization, and that's it. End to end, I can carry out the DevOps activities. So this helps me quickly set up the things, one, and also learn without wasting much of time in figuring out all these things. The other scenario, like let's say I have to give a quick demo for a company on project management aspects, right? In that case, I have to create hundreds of work items with all the relation like epic feature, then user story, then task, then build all those relationship, right? And enter the data. A lot of data has to be entered, right? With all the for all the fields, which may be a humongous task, and it will be a, believe me, it will be a tedious one to do it manually, right? But with demo generator, with couple of clicks, all the hundreds of work items are created with all the data, all the dashboards, like pie chart, all the bar chart and widgets are all configured in my dashboard. My work items are configured, my Kanban settings are done. It can be tag styling or coloring, right? So what I'm trying to say is, like instead of spending like 1 week or 2 weeks for you can say data entry kind of work, I can just use demo generator, and in a few minutes it will have all the things ready for me. And the other main advantage of this is I can do this whenever I want. Let's say I have done a demo to a customer, I can just delete the team project. And whenever again I need a demo environment to be set up, quickly I can do it within a couple of clicks. And exactly same environment is there for me. So I don't have to spend too much of time. Yeah. So yes, I think the project is created. Let me navigate to the project. Yeah, and you can see here. It has stored like this: the project is created, teams, board, column settings, build definition, release definition, the work items, all these are created in this project. Yeah, so this is my project Smart Hotel, which is generated using Azure DevOps demo generator. Let me quickly go to the dashboard, and you can see that the entire dashboard is created with all the settings. You can see, otherwise it would have taken a lot of time for me to set up all these things, and now with just a couple of clicks I have all these data and the charts available, which can let's say I'm a trainer, it's easy for me to show a demo now. And let me go to the backlogs, and here you can see it has created a lot of work items. Let me go to the view, board view, and I can see here it has created all these, you can say user stories or PBIs, and for each of these things there are child items, all the tasks already linked. Then let me go to the repos. Yeah, here also you can see the sample source code is there, And the you know the one more advantage is it is with history, so all the history is available here, right? So I can you know even check like whether any pull requests are there. Yes, you can see even pull requests are created on behalf of me. Okay, so it is basically setting up the you know entire DevOps environment for me. Now let me go to the pipelines. This is my build pipeline. Let me click on edit, and I can see all the steps here. Okay, all the build tasks like you know required to you know build this application. It's a .NET Core application, and all the tasks are available. So I have to just you know save and queue the build, and my application will be compiled. And let me go to the release pipeline, and we can see even the release pipeline is set up with all the jobs. Yeah, so there will be some you know like settings that has to be done. Like I have to select a agent pool, and I have to select you know my Azure connection details. Like if I go here, I have to choose the Azure connection, my subscription details. So once this is done, I can you know compile and my you know deploy my application to my Azure subscription. Yeah, I think that's it. So I just wanted to show you the demo generator tool and how useful it is for anyone who wants to learn Azure DevOps. We can use demo generator with all the templates, and we can learn all the concepts. Or it can be used by a trainer or a MVP or a DevOps consultant, you know, either to show a demo to our clients. To do a POC or a pilot, right? Or you know even do a classroom training, right? Or even onboard a you know a batch of resources to Azure DevOps. So there are many you know use cases for demo generator, and you know I've seen even few people using it like to move the data from one project to another project, right? Like we saw the private template, so I extract the data from my one of the project from one Azure DevOps account, and I can you know once it is extracted, it's a kind of a template, and use the template and create a spin up a project in my another Azure DevOps account with all the data like work item, source code, build, release pipelines, everything, even dashboard settings, which otherwise you know we can say a Herculean task to do it. The links to the demo generator, the lab, and you know other URLs will be provided in the description. Thank you for watching the video.